well, good morning. And so every day I start my day with a practice, and I thought I'd invite you in this morning to see how I do what I do. Initially, the ingredients that I tell my class to bring are an imagination and an inner smile. I do this for the fun of it. And I start off with what is called Bamboo Blows in the Wind. And it's just a gentle rocking. Side to side. Front to back. And now I have an awareness of my feet are rooted. My toes sometimes can curl. I can sink my heels in. I can push out with my toes to the side and pull in with the heels. So I'm doing all of these things in my feet, gentle but aware. Scratch my nose. But so feet sunken, solid, but aware of their parts. My knees are bent, just slightly bent. My tail is slightly tucked. I'm just settling in a little bit here, settling into my legs. My cat wants to have some attention. My arms and my hands are relaxed, and my shoulders are relaxed. I'm breathing in my belly, expanding. Exhaling. Being aware of the breath. Something we do 12 to 20 times a minute on average and generally shallow. Becoming aware of the breath is one of the secrets of the ancients, of the tribal, of the aboriginal peoples and their medicine. Inhaling oxygen. Exhaling carbon dioxide. Long inhales, but extra attention paid to the exhale. And so my shoulders are relaxed, my body's relaxed, my head is sort of dangling, it's from a string. What we're doing is we're extending the spine. We're sinking and stretching at the same time. And this is the most difficult part of the practice. It's called relaxing. Deep inhale and exhale like a balloon is going when our body sinks. Sink weight into one leg, making this leg substantial and this insubstantial. So this 70%, 80%, 90%, and then 100% of my weight is there, and I step out. Shift the weight over here. Shifting the weight back and forth. Just gentle movements. Sinking. Pumping. Sinking, pumping. So the imagination is like a muscle. The more we use it, the stronger it gets. We're going to be playing. It's taken me years to understand, and my understanding continues to grow about chi. Energy, a breath. If chi is breath, or paying attention to chi, my practice has begun 15 or more years ago. I've had many teachers, many different forms of Tai Chi. Qigong. The emphasis and my interest has focused on the Qigong part of this practice. Tai Chi is a martial art. Every move has a meaning in a martial sense. Tai Chi began being developed 400, 500, 600 years ago. Forms have 108 moves, and then people shortened it and cut it in half and cut it in half again. Qigong is the great, 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 great grandmother of Tai Chi. Thousands of years ago, it was developed as a healing art, as a wellness study, as a way to maintain your health. So Qi in Qigong energy, can be breath. Say it's breath. Qi is breath. Gong is practice. Attention, paying attention, working with Qigong. So we're doing Qigong, and it's the breath, and it's the energy that's around us. It's the imagination of this thing called Qi. That does grow as you use it. So we're going to be imagining, playing with chi. Hands are out. And this is just a simple, but it's a meditation. Because what we want to do, what I want to do for myself, standing here right now, is have an awareness of right now. We're going to take an energy ball and call it the past, and another one and call it the future. The future is a mystery, and the past is history, and it's the monkey chatter in our brains that we want to take those two and bring them into the present. Bring them into now. Stopping that chatter, paying attention to our body, our feet, our knees, our tail, our breath. Now, here we are now. Here I am, now, the present. It is a present in another sense of the word, in that it is a gift. It's a gift you can give yourself, bringing your awareness into the now, taking a moment. Standing meditations where you can start with your hands a little low out from your body and hold this posture. Hold it for a minute or two or five. In the beginning, we want to start small. So we hold the posture, we can count our breaths. So we hold the posture for five breaths. bring our hands up a little higher. And again, hold the posture, relax, tuck tail, knees bent. Five more breaths. And we can stay here longer, but for now we're going to move on. And now our arms are higher and we're hugging a tree. And again, we can do this for a minute, or three, or five. If you can get up to 5 minutes, you'll notice changes in your body, where your attention goes, your shoulders, your wrists. Look at your hands. Flex your fingers. Relax, the hardest thing. So there's a standing qigong that I do, looking out the window. And some mornings I'll do it for 10 minutes. I've been known occasionally to do it for 20 minutes, just standing. A basic beginner's move is also one of the most advanced. Pay attention to your body. Stay in a position. Slowly bring your hands down. Relax. Imagine and keep that smile.